past 40 years, if you look at this ocean, you don't see much that's changed. It's not that visible from the surface. You still see some birds flying around. You see seals on the surface. You don't see dolphins here. But under the surface, quite a lot has changed. I think we have to understand what goes on out here, and that's what Scripps is involved with. When you can't see something, you don't know how it's changed, and it's not visible to a typical person that just comes to the beach. But if you understand the amount of sea life that's present, the decline in the amount of sea life, the decline in the fisheries, the decline in animals like abalone and others out here, you begin to understand that we're having an enormous impact on the web of life that's in the ocean. That's the same web of life that supports us. I think the biggest thing Scripps does is help us understand what's going on out here so that we can act policies and that can preserve what we want to preserve in this ocean.
Well, the San Diego community has a fabulous relationship with water, whether you're going to the beach with a picnic with your family, or you're scuba diving, or you're surfing, or you're a tourist here visiting us specifically because of our beaches and the fabulous weather and lifestyle that we have here. Not just in the tourism and the community aspect, but in our economy. You know, the Port of San Diego, the military, the Navy is here for a reason. We have great access to our oceans. And the work that Scripps is doing and the oceanographic research that they do informs tourism, community use of our waterways, military and commercial use of our waterways. San Diego was historically a fishing community. The tuna fleet was here, and that helped build Point Loma, where we are right now, and all of the San Diego area. So we have a long relationship with the water.
The signs of climate change are all around us, melting ice caps, glaciers, rising sea levels. And here in San Diego, where we have such beautiful coastlines, we need to think about the impact that rising sea level would have. And it's a threat not only to our own community, but to coastal communities around the world. Mother Nature is an incredibly ingenious chemist. And the ocean is the largest feature of the planet, and it is the most biodiverse. By taking advantage of the samples that we can get from the sea, once again we're finding new and novel chemistries in natural products.
Jeff and I have lived in Point Loma for about 10 years now. We've always kind of looked down at this pier and thought, what's going on down there? And we asked some friends of ours, and it's Marfac, the Scripps Pier. And so we decided about a year and a half ago to start the Krinsk Research Advancement Initiative. And what's so important about that initiative, students and professors are here saving the world right here in San Diego, and we hope that some of their discoveries turn out to be businesses right here in the community.
The greatest challenge facing civilization at the moment is water and energy. And Scripps Institution of Oceanography is right in the center of the research on water resources and management.
We evolved along with this ocean, along with this life, and to the extent that we see it declining, it's an indicator to us that maybe our future prospects are diminished if we're not careful.
And Scripps' presence in San Diego makes a true difference in how our community, our economic, our tourism, our families that live here can utilize that water resource.